You might have noticed that there is one typeface used more often than not. It's the favorite of the world's major brands, US government, EU countries, and many others. We are, of course, talking about Helvetica and its growing popularity. So how and why did Helvetica become so popular? Let's first take a look at the story behind this widely used typeface. Its history. Helvetica was developed by Max Meidinger in cooperation with Eduard Hoffmann in 1957. Their goal was to develop a neutral typeface that had great clarity. Designed to match the success of Universe, Helvetica became popular almost instantly. By 1965, Amsterdam Continental started to focus on Helvetica instead of Accidens Grotesque. In the late 70s, and especially the 80s, Helvetica became an important part of digital printing, as Linotype licensed it to Xerox, Apple, and Adobe. Its popularity has been steadily growing ever since. Let's look at what makes it so unique. The beauty of Helvetica lies in its simplicity and clean design, which is a big part of Helvetica's success story. Let's take a look at some of its most recognizable characteristics. Narrow apertures. Tight, display-oriented spacing between the letters. Tall X height. An oblique instead of the italic style. Wide capitals. Square-shaped letter S. Rounded off the square tail of the letter R. The concavely curved stem on 7. Bracketed top flag on 1. One thing to keep in mind is that the tight spacing might pose a legibility problem at small sizes. In cases where this matters, you should choose a font which makes all letters wide. So who's using it now? In order to help expand Helvetica's popularity, a large number of its variants have been released, including for new languages and weights. Those variants include, but are not limited to, Helvetica Lite, Helvetica Inserat, Helvetica Compressed, Helvetica Rounded, Helvetica Narrow, Helvetica Textbook, etc. It is safe to say that today, Helvetica is one of the most popular and widely used sans-serif typefaces. It is often used for commercial word marks, including those of Panasonic, Motorola, BMW, General Motors, American Apparel, Kawasaki, Jeep, Nestle, Kroger, Knoll, and many others. The US government uses it for all kinds of official documents, like income tax forms, for example. Similarly, the Canadian government uses it as its identifying typeface. The United States Television Rating System also uses Helvetica, and even NASA used it on the Space Shuttle Orbiter. This typeface is also commonly used in transportation settings in the US, Canada, UK, etc. What this means is that you have probably spent a good part of your life surrounded by Helvetica without even knowing it. Could we live without Helvetica? So now that we know what Helvetica is and how widely it has been used for the past 50 years, the question is, what would our lives without Helvetica look like? Luckily, someone had asked themselves this question already, so we can learn from their experience. A couple of years ago, a designer from New York by the name of Cyrus Highsmith decided to spend one day without Helvetica. The rules of this game were simple. Whenever he saw something spelled in Helvetica, he had to look the other way. That meant buying or using no products with this font on their labels, using no Helvetica-signed public transportation, reading no instructions spelled in this typeface, etc. You might think that this is no big deal to spend one day like that, but you would be terribly wrong. As soon as Highsmith climbed out of bed, his troubles with avoiding Helvetica began. First, he couldn't wash his clothes properly because the washing instructions were all written in this font. Then, he couldn't eat his usual breakfast because the label of his favorite yogurt was in Helvetica as well. He couldn't even read his usual newspaper because the New York Times is full of Helvetica. Once he left his house, he knew he couldn't use the subway, but luckily, he managed to find one Helvetica-free bus. When the lunchtime came, he had to switch restaurants to find one with a Helvetica-free menu. Not to mention the trouble he went through paying for his food and transportation, since the new US bills are also covered in Helvetica. He had a particularly hard time at work, because although he deleted Helvetica from his computer, he couldn't browse the internet. He finally got home and thought he would just spend the rest of the day watching TV. You couldn't do that either because the controls had Helvetica on them. So, what would our lives without Helvetica look like? Would you use it? Now let's look at this typeface from a designer's perspective, a designer who's creating work for his or her clients. Would you use it in a logo, a brochure, or a website? You would, if you'd want to play it safe. Helvetica is a typeface that is recognized for its neutrality, precision, calmness, balance, wide range. You must admit, it does have some personality to it, however, it doesn't draw too much attention to itself. So does that mean it is a bad typeface? Not at all. The only problem with it is that it's overused, becoming a victim of its own success. From the moment Helvetica was designed, everybody recognized the potential hidden in its simplicity and clean design. As the time went by, it became one of the most popular typefaces on the globe, and at this point, it is almost impossible to imagine our lives without it. Are you using it in your designs? If so, how often? Write a comment below and let us know. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button. Don't want to miss the next video? Hit the subscribe button and click the bell beside it. Thank you for watching and check out these neat videos that we previously created.